See that right there? It's manual, baby. Chad. Kidney shot.
I'm ready. Aki Kareem for BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined by big heavyweight prospect, Emmanuel Odiasse. Did I say it right?
That's right.
I got it right, brother. All right, and you're over here at Collier's and Moston Boxing Gym today. Firstly, everyone's going to want to know what brings you over to Manchester and to this gym.
You know, I was here in Manchester 2017. My uncle lives here. So I was starting boxing in 2016. And I thought to myself, England boxing is very strong. So I'm going to fly out Manchester to my uncle's place and just look for a gym. Back then I was texting Lawrence O'Coley on Instagram and I said to him, Lawrence, I'm in Manchester, do you know any good boxing gyms? And he sent me the contact of Lyndon Arthur. Then I texted Lyndon and Lyndon told me to pull up Collier's and Moston. So I came here, really skinny guy, still tall, I was 17 or 18, very skinny, and I pulled up to the gym, all these guys looking at me. So I had a chat with Pat, and he told me to come in the morning, train with the pros. And yeah, so we started having contact, stayed in touch, and after 1 week I came to the gym, started training with the pros. So yeah, now I'm back in the UK. I'm only visiting, I'm here for 1 week because I'm visiting my uncle. And I've spent the last 2 weeks in London, sparring with AJ. So yeah. That brought me here again.
Lots to talk about here. Firstly, you can't just drop in the fact that you was last week in London with AJ and not tell us a bit more about that. So that's a big one. I've seen some footage of you guys out there. So you were part of a just training alongside him. And what was that experience like?
It's crazy experience because I've been in there with a world champion before, last year, Deontay Wilder. And so it's my second time with a world champion. So I was still nervous, but I felt like what it feels to be in there with a champion, you get what I'm saying? So AJ was always my inspiration, even back in the day. I remember 2017 I was watching the AJ Klitschko fight here in Manchester with my uncle. So he was just like, I've seen him on TV and now I've seen him in person, and then I'm in the ring with him. So it's just crazy experience, and I'm just thankful, and I thank God every day, because without him I wouldn't be here. So yeah, I'm just rolling with the punches.
Rolling with the punches indeed. Now obviously there is this massive fight which has been talked about. Well, we've got nothing confirmed yet, we've got the signed contract, but without saying too much, obviously, how's AJ looking in camp? Are you impressed with what you've seen?
Well, he's not in camp, so he's just staying fit,
right?
So that's the crazy thing. He's just staying fit, but he's so determined. I've learned so much just from the 2 weeks being with him. Like he's just literally in the gym all day when he's not doing media work. So like he's very, very determined and he wants it. And that's why I think he's gonna get it.
Oh, you think so? You think he's gonna do the job and beat Tyson?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, is it that determination? I mean, you're 22 now, so you're still a young guy yourself. You know, is that determination something which, you know, you look up to and does it inspire you along in your own journey?
Definitely. That determination is what you need when you want to become a champion and a great champion like AJ. See, he lost his titles in America. Lost to Andy Ruiz, and I think what makes him the great champion is how he handled that loss. Came back, he went back to the drawing board, did whatever he needed to do, and got the win. So, and he was not like making any excuses after the defeat. So that's what like a great champion is to me. Yeah. So I'm just happy that I got to know him. And I'm learning from everything that he does, you know?
You also mentioned being in camp with Deontay Wilder. I've seen the footage of you there trying to sort of replicate. I know there's only one Tyson Fury, of course, we know that. But your job in there was to try and replicate him a little bit. again, Wilder, massive puncher, great heavyweight champion. How was that as well? Was it different? Is the American experience different to the UK experience in some ways?
Yeah, it's always different when you spar in different fighters. And with Wilder, the thing was, I remember from 2015 or whenever, I just started boxing. I've been in the boxing gym for like 2 weeks, and I've seen a fight of Wilder in the States with my brother. And he was so quick, he looked so strong, and he was knocking the guy out. So 5 years later, I'm in the gym with him. And I was like really nervous because like it's sparring, but still you gotta be prepared for everything. And I just had to be ready for whatever comes. So yeah, that was a crazy experience and different. Of course different than AJ. AJ powerful as well, but just different type of fighter.
All you need now is to spar Tyson and you've got the big three.
Yeah man, I got this Tyson Fury, if you see that, call me. Nah, I'm Team AJ now.
Oh, okay, alright, I see. Yeah. You've got to be careful where you say that in Manchester, you
I'm
know.
Team AJ. Pull fair up, enough. Tyson, pull up, colour us a mustard.
Tyson used to train with Pac, you know, years back.
Yeah, I heard the stories.
Yeah. Tell us a bit about your background from Hamburg in Germany.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I know Germany is a big fight country. They love the boxing. They've had some great fighters pass through historically, but not necessarily many big heavyweights. So what's it like being a big heavyweight based in Germany, Hamburg?
It's a great thing because, as you mentioned, Germany is a country that always had like great boxers, but I felt like boxing is, like the interest for boxing was going down the last couple of years. But right now we got a group of very interesting boxers in Hamburg, in the gym that I'm training with. Our coach Christian Morales is doing a great job. We got good management. My management company is called PIX. You can look that up if you want to. We got some great talent on there. And we're just helping each other. We're growing together. So I feel like I'm still not turning professional yet. I still haven't turned professional yet, but when I'm turning professional, I want to like spark the interest in the public eye in Germany, in the UK, and once I reach a level in America as well, like all over the world. So I feel like we have a very, very strong, interesting group over there. You guys have to definitely check it out.
Oh yeah, we definitely will. Yeah. I've heard lots about you though, to be fair. I've heard you're the real deal.
Yeah.
But of course, We need to see that in the professional ranks, don't we? So tell us what you've done in the amateur ranks, which makes people say, this guy's the real deal.
That's the crazy thing. I only had 13 amateur fights.
Yeah.
So that's the crazy thing. I haven't had like the chance to fight for the Olympics yet. That was my biggest dream because my inspiration was Muhammad Ali. So I wanted that gold medal. But Germany got a strong guy in the heavyweight division. And there's like, he's already plan to go to the Olympics. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I kind of came in too late. So what I'm looking to do is maybe turn professional. I'm really not sure at the moment. So I'm looking to maybe turn professional this year and go back to the Olympics 2024. So turn back to an amateur when it's 224. But a lot of people told me once you turn professional,
you won't turn back.
You never turn back.
I know some pros have talked about turning back amateur for the Olympics. I know Manny Pacquiao talked about it at one point. It never happened.
It never happened. No, yeah.
You'll see, especially in the heavyweight division, there's a lot of money, a lot of prestige. You might get addicted to that.
I just got to stay grounded. That's what Pat's telling me all the time. Like, he's telling me all the time that I should stay focused. And I should never let all the media attention or whatever get to my head. So yeah, we just got to see what we're doing. Build me up slowly, take our time. I'm still very young for heavyweight, only 22. So just taking the time and not rush things. So when I have like 10 fights under my belt and it's 2023, I could definitely wait and fight for the Olympics in Paris, which would be a huge market, fighting in France, Europe, and winning a gold medal. So we just have to see what we're doing, but I feel like I'm pretty confident being in the ring, so I feel relaxed. I think I got everything what you need as a pro, so might check it out, and if it works, it works. We stay professional,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah. Well, I'd certainly be interested to see you turning pro, because I've heard so much about you, and I know from your experience with the sparring side of things, it'll be exciting for people to watch. You're also, you're the sort of heavyweight who's in shape. You're not like a, you know, a heavyweight who just relies on power. You know, you're in shape, you're an athlete.
Yes, sir.
So being that said, you know, living the life, that really, you've got everything to look forward to, haven't you? You're especially 22 years old. That must be an exciting prospect to look forward to that.
Yeah, I'm very excited for the future, and I got big dreams, like real, real, real big dreams. And that's what's special. Like when I came to the gym first time, to the Colliers Mustang, Pat was looking at me. Not the first time, but like 1 week training, 2 weeks training. And I was only boxing for 1 week, for 1 year there. Pat was looking at me. He looked me dead in the eyes and said, "Listen, son, you got something. You're gonna be a world champion." And that meant so much to me, because me knowing Pat, like, the word of Pat is like really important to everyone in this gym. So when he said that to me, that sparked something inside of me. And after that, like 2 years later, I found out, I was talking to him on the phone. He said the exact same thing to Tyson Fury back in the day.
He did.
So that's a big inspiration for me. Tyson went all the way. I'm trying to go all the way, even reach higher potential. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Well, and another interesting thing is obviously seeing you here in the UK, seeing you talk about Manchester, seeing you talk about London. Would there be any opportunity? Are you thinking of perhaps one day maybe even relocating here to start your career out in the pros?
Yes, I'm open to anything. It's just about seeing what's the best for me.
Like the heavyweight scene's here now.
Yeah, heavyweight scene is popping in the UK. I get that, and Pat's a great trainer. So we got to see what we do in the future. I'm open to anything, and yeah, I can't really tell about. I can't really say anything because I haven't made plans yet, but like it's really exciting. Just I got so many opportunities right now, so I got to be really careful and pick the right one, because I don't want to do any mistakes, you know. And that's what great, that's what, like, that is what is so good about today's age, because we can learn from the past. We got it. I got it on my phone now. I can look up, I can search up any fighter from the past and see what he's done wrong. So I can learn from that and make my own good decisions. But you never make the perfect decision. There's gonna always be mistakes in life. You gotta learn from them. Yeah.
And you know, for people that are watching this and thinking, yeah, I wanna see this guy fight, or what's your fighting style like?
I would say I got my own fighting style, but I take inspiration from older guys. Just being in there with AJ, seeing some tricks, seeing what he does. My favorite fighter of all time is Muhammad Ali, especially because of the things that he's done outside of the ring. And when I was young, I used to fight, and kids were coming to me after the fight and say, "You look exactly like Muhammad Ali." So that was like really inspiring for me, because that's my inspiration. So my fighting style is kind of like Ali, because I'm moving my legs, I'm staying active, moving my upper body. You could say Tyson Fury, especially the last fight from Tyson Fury. I like the way he was fighting, coming forward with the Krunk style, Manny Stewart style. And yeah, I just want to mix everything in there. Like Vladimir Klitschko was a great champion. He used his legs pretty well when he worked with Emmanuel Stewart, so I take my inspiration from there as well. You can even take inspiration from Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson was a shorter guy, moving around, but still you can learn a lot from him. So I'm just taking in everything and using it for my own use. So all the people out there that want to see me fight, just watch me.
Watch out for this guy, man. Watch out for Emmanuel, because he's coming. You know, if you turn pro, great. If you carry on saying amateur, great. Please let us know, because we would love to follow this journey.
Let you know.
It's going to be exciting. Guys, check this guy out. Do you want to give your Instagram handle?
My Instagram is Emmanuel Odiasa. So it's just E-M-A-N-U-E-L. Odiasa, O-D-I-S-A.
Okay, Emmanuel Odiasa, 22 years old, 6'8", from Hamburg, Germany.
Yes.
He sparred with AJ, he sparred with Wilder, and he's looking to make a big splash onto the heavyweight scene. Thanks for your time, bro.
Thanks for your time, I appreciate you.